So Delmarvins died on 9/11 and Delmarvins were born on 9/11. Maybe that's the best example of all, that no matter how bleak things get, life finds a way to continue. It goes on. After 9/11, we put aside our differences, at least for a little bit. We volunteered our time, we gave blood, we gave money, we did what we could. We remembered what it was like to be a part of a team. And then we hugged the people we loved, we went back to work, we even learned to laugh again. Some people you'll talk with say that 9/11 is the day that changed America. I don't know if that's the case. Maybe it's just the day that reminded us of what being an American is all about. Kelly. In Washington, D.C., police with automatic rifles are patrolling the grounds of the U.S. Capitol. Anti-aircraft batteries have been placed around the city, and the government is warning key industries and utilities, beware of employees who might have been planted by terror groups. Now, the possibility of a terrorist attack has much of the country on edge tonight. Some people preparing for the worst. ABC's Lauren Rogers has the latest. Private companies which offer flying ambulance services to take patients from one hospital to another want the chance to respond to some of the emergency calls, which are now handled only by the Maryland State Police Aviation Division. And so they're asking lawmakers to lift what they consider a state monopoly on emergency helicopter service. But Aviation Division troopers...